Revolution and disruption, people like to use a lot, but by definition, that's pain, and it's different. So I would say the first thing we have to recognize is, why hasn't healthcare joined the consumer revolution, right? Why can you be around the day after Thanksgiving in your pajamas watching Game of Thrones doing all your holiday shopping, but if you have a stomach ache, you can't go and find a doctor? The technology's there. It's the use of the technology. So the first thing we have to do is really encourage the use of technology and have patients not accept that they can't do things in healthcare that they can do in everything else. And then the second thing, in our academic entities, we have to recognize that the old way of just incenting NIH funding and NSF funding, all of which are important, is not the new way of transformation disruption. So we have to have inventors have a path to professorship in a very similar way that NIH-funded researchers do. And that's something that I think some places are doing. There's a National Academy of Inventors that we're part of that is starting to look at how do you keep people in academic entities that are coming up with new inventions. And then the last thing is that I think there are some opportunities for government to actually start to promote those kind of things. When you look at what Anish Chopra says in our journal Healthcare Transformation, there's funding that the government has started to do, not to do the innovation in the government, but to support people that are willing to transform and disrupt the technology of healthcare. All of those have to work together. And in this wonderful world of this book, they all start to get it, that they can work together and actually disrupt healthcare and have that healthcare revolution.